The plan to build a Hyperloop between Pittsburgh and Chicago is moving forward. A feasibility study released today found that the project would create more than 900,000 jobs in the next 30 years and cost more than $25 billion to build. Target 11's Rick Earl's been bringing us every development in this story. He is live with what else this study reveals. Rick.
Yeah, David, the bottom line here, the study found there's a need for a Hyperloop system, but perhaps more importantly, a way to build it and to keep it running.
The Hyperloop is another big game changer.
At the Great Lakes Science Center in Cleveland today, members of a regional planning commission unveiled a much-anticipated feasibility study on a Hyperloop connecting Chicago to Cleveland and Pittsburgh.
Does this sound like pie in the sky? Of course it does. But if we want to get a slice of that pie, we have to start thinking big. The same old will get us just that.
The nearly two-year study found that a Hyperloop system between the three cities would create 900,000 jobs and pump billions of dollars into the economies.
The results of these studies are unprecedented. The study reveals and shows that Hyperloop is profitable and also brings massive economic benefit to the region.
Last year, Target 11 got an exclusive behind-the-scenes look at the world's first Hyperloop test track near Las Vegas. For the Cleveland project, there are several proposed routes. One would go to Pittsburgh International Airport, then head to the city, traveling under the Mon River into downtown. At 449 miles per hour, it would take 19 minutes. The study also said it would revolutionize the transportation of freight, delivering it faster than trucks and cheaper than air. And the study found that revenue generated from passengers and freight would support the system.
All of this means that it's a financeable system that requires no subsidies, local, state, federal, at all, and that it can support its entire capital cost by itself.
And a ticket to Cleveland would cost about $30. The next step in this process is an environmental study of the entire proposed route. That's the very latest reporting live this evening in Fineview. Rick Earl, Channel 11 News.